Hi, everyone. Today, I will introduce you guys about where to go. If you plan to visit Seoul in the South Korea during December or in the winter season, I'm here to show you what Christmas looks like in Seoul and to show you the atmosphere of this incredible city. And before starting, I have to ask you all a favor. If you like this clips, please, please, please support me a bit by press subscribe button and press like button too. That will help me a lot. I mean, really. And if you like my content, please feel free to write down any recommend below, and also please share this clip to your friends and family. Thank you so much. Here are the top 5 places to visit in Seoul during December Christmas season. 1. Lotte Department Store and Shinsegae Department Store in Myeongdong area. 2. Starfield Library, which is located in the Starfield Coex Mall at the first floor. 3. Lotte World Magic Island and Lotte World Tower Charlotte Garden. 4. Christmas Village in the Hyundai Seoul Department Store top floor. 5. Myeongdong Cathedral. All of the details will be explained at the end section of this video, and also Google Maps locations of 5 places. I have written it down in the description below, so don't worry about how to go. Just follow the Google Maps location and all the details that I provide you all through this clips. Let's go! Number 1, the first place is Lotte Department Store Main Store and the Shinsegae Department Store, both of them located just nearby the Myeongdong area. To get there, you need to go by subway train on the line number 2, or green color line, and take a subway train to Yuljilo, Ilgar Station. After you arrive the station, go to the exit 7. For someone who are not familiar with Seoul Subway Station, you can go to their website seoulmetro.co.kr. After that, you will stand right in front of the Lotte Hotel Seoul. Every year at December, this area will be decorated with many, many illumination lighting. Many of South Korean citizen, foreigner expat, and traveler will come to this place to see the Christmas illumination. This is one of the Seoul's most popular shopping area. The Lotte Department Store Main Store is the flagship store of Lotte Group. The building is an eye-catching landmark of Seoul and overlooks the Enseol Tower and the Han River. And this year, Lotte Group company spent a record 6 billion won, or 5.2 million US dollars on Christmas illuminations. The opening ceremony of Lotte Department Store's Main Store in Seoul was held on December 12th. And the store has begun to prepare for Christmas shopping. The Lotte Department Store Main Store in Seoul is well known for its annual Christmas light. Every year, the Shinsegae Department Store collaborates with Lotte Group. They both try to make a light installation show in Seoul Central Area District. In this year, both of them lit up the streets of Seoul with a gorgeous Christmas light installation, which is so bright they could be seen from miles away, as you guys can see it on this video right now. And also, both of them are two of the most famous department stores in Seoul. If you have never been to these stores before, then it is the right time to visit these places and enjoy the Christmas lights. The outside is decorated with Christmas lights, and you can also see many stores inside that offer various products for all ages. Lotte Department Store has designed a magic moment display for a Christmas campaign. This display makes people feel like they are in their own Christmas dream, which is what you just see in the video. It is very, very beautiful red backdrop on the entrance of the store. I really, really, really love it. This year, the Lotte Department Store's Main Store launched a Christmas campaign alongside with its sister stores in Japan and China. As a part of the global marketing strategy that has been carried out since November 1st, the store put up 6 video maps with displays of products and scenes from around the globe on its third floor lobby space to create an atmosphere of holiday cheer for customers who enter the store. The department store had various photo zones featuring Instagrammable Christmas trees, as well as a photo zone at the entrance and the wall. And also inside the store. The store is decorated with 1.3 million LED lights for this year's Christmas campaign, instead of putting up a traditional Christmas tree. In South Korea, Christmas is not a public holiday. But some of you might surprise that. For many Koreans, the period around Christmas is an important time to spend with their families and friends. Christianity in Korea has been on a steep incline in the past few decades, and I guess it might be the reason why Christmas season are become more and more important time for everyone in South Korea. Shinsegae, a department store in Seoul. This year, came with a themed magical wonderland. The department store's decorations are strikingly gorgeous, and there are various activities. There are even some opportunities to take a photo with Santa. If you walk inside, you will see many types of Christmas products at this place because there are a lot of different shops inside that sell items with different themes such as food, clothes, electronics, and more. Okay. For the direction of walking, just open the Google Maps location. I have already put the link at the description below. After you guys start from station exit 7, just walk on the south direction along on the Nam De Monroe Street. The Lotte Mall will be on your right hand side. Go straight on by the south direction until you arrive the big junction. The Shinsegae at department store will located at the opposite side. Next. Number 2. The Starfield Library. It is located in the Coex Mall. It is a 5-story library. Located in the Central Children's Library of Coex Mall, Starfield Library is a 5-story library. That was open to the public on November 30, 2009 and has been open to the public ever since. The library has been designed with a concept of young people in mind, and it offers a wide selection of books, as well as different kinds of educational programs for both children and adults. There are many places that are worth visiting for those who go to Starfield Library at Coex Mall for the first time. Because it takes about an hour and a half to walk around the entire building. This year, Starfield Library chose to decorate their place with a bright, shining golden Christmas trees inside of their library. As you can see now on the screen, which makes it a very nice spot to take photos at during the Christmas season, both on the daytime and when they turn on all of their lights as well. The Christmas season is a beautiful time of year to explore Seoul City. You may want to take a walk around to see the lights and decorations or head into a nice place for some Instagram photos. The key is to dress warmly, be mindful of traffic, and avoid the crowds. About how to go there, you guys can take the subway train to Bongsa Station and take an exit 7. Walk in the south direction straight along on the Yeongdongdae Row Street. Go all the way until you reach the entrance of Starfield Coex Mall and turn left to the mall. You can enter through Gate 4 or Gate 3. After arrive, go down to the first floor and there will be the Starfield Library. Or please refer to the Google Maps location, which I put it down in the description. Next. Number 3. The Lotte World Tower, Charlotte Garden, and the Lotte World Magic Island. Both are located in the southeast area of Seoul City. The Lotte Tower complex located just next to Jeomseol Subway Station, Exit 2. It is comprised of 6 buildings. The tallest building is the Lotte World Tower 1 with a 123-story building height. They offer various features such as an observation deck area, and also a Christmas tree that lights up every December. On the top floor, you can take in the sky bridge to see the nice panorama view of Seoul City. For anyone who are interested in it, I recommend to go there around half an hour before the sunset time. The other building included amusement park, Lotte World and Magic Island, duty free, shopping mall, and Zetaplex. On the ground floor, If you guys walk to the Charlotte Garden, which is located between Lotte Tower and the Suk Chan Lake, just taking a short walk along with the beautiful views of the building and lighting decoration, this is definitely something worth checking it out. There are lots of Christmas tree and illumination decorating along the area. As you can see on the screen now. Really, really pretty during Christmas time. Atmosphere around the area really lively, surrounded by children voice, Christmas song, and a lot of Korean couples. I think you can absorb the good vibes here. That's remind me of my nice childhood memories. For me, Lotte World Tower today become one of Seoul City's landmarks. And also it has become one of my favorite place too. I have a recommendation for all you guys, if you all tired from a long walking around this area, and if you all hungry, there are a nice burger around here. Gordon Ramsay Burger, their shop just a few short walk from this Charlotte Garden on the level B1 Lotte Tower. After they made its debut at the world's tallest building, Lotte World Tower, the burger has been served in several Gordon Ramsay restaurants all over the world. But this is the first time it has been sold in Korea. After catching the attention of many people with its grand opening on March 15th, the Gordon Ramsay Burger has been a popular item to eat before you die. I will tell you why to choose this restaurant. You are probably wondering what makes this burger world famous. Well, it is a beef patty topped with barbecue sauce, smoked onions, and crispy applewood bacon. Their dish is made using Wagyu beef from Kobe, Japan. This time, unfortunately, I didn't take a photo and video to let you guys see the burger. I'm sorry about that. Okay, we come to the next place. Lotte World Amusement Park and the Magic Island. Located just on the left side of the Lotte department store. Normal park tickets price is 47,000 won. If you enter the park after 16 p.m., and it is exclude folk museum. Currently theme of the park is Miracle Winter Christmas. This year, the Castle Christmas Lighting Showtime is 20:40 p.m. And it is at the outside building, the Magic Island. I recommend you guys to go there before the show start 20 to 25 minutes. Because there will be full and crowded. And there will be a parade show all day long. You guys can check their timetable at the front desk or on their website. LotteWorld.com. And here is the Magic Island Christmas Light Show. They will start the show around 20:40 p.m. Remember that you have to be here before the show start at least 20 minutes.
My name is Lotte the Wizard. Now, a marvelous magic show will unfold before your eyes.
Another tips. If you guys come here with your love or with your friends, there are a cloth rental shop inside this park. You can rent a Korn University uniform dress for a few hours and enjoy the Korean nostalgic memories during in the park. And when you are in the park, you will see many couples. Came here with that kind of university uniform and take a photo together. Enjoy their young looking appearance again, which is really cute. As you guys can see on this video now, I wonder how can they make this lighting show. Looks so realistic. I have to give them a thumbs up. lighting show take around 20 minutes. In this clips, I only cut some part of the show to sample you guys, to let you all to see how beautiful it is. At the time I record this clips, on the bridge to the Magic Island, in front of me, and behind me, and also at the back of me, there are no any empty space to stand. I think this show is worth the money, and many Koreans just came here for just attend this show only. And guess what, after here, they all will go for some nice bar to drink, or go for some nice Korean barbecue. The only words that I can say to you guys is that you have to come here. This is really gorgeous. About how to came here. Charlotte Garden and the Lotte World Amusement Park, the Magic Island. Both of them located next to the Jeonseol Station. I have put the Google Maps location in the description below, and you all can see it on the screen now too. Exit 2 for the Lotte World Tower, Charlotte Garden located in the area between Lotte World Tower and Jaebaek Coffee. Exit 4 for the Lotte World Amusement Park. You guys just walk straight until around Toy R Us building. Over there will be an entrance. And then, number 4. Christmas Village at the Hyundai Seoul Department Store, top floor. The Hyundai Seoul opened a 35,580 square feet Christmas market in the season, which their houses uniquely decorated in a wooden cabins, drawing a huge queues of people waiting to take selfies inside. This place is all over my feed on Instagram. Christmas is just around the corner. Hyundai shopping malls are decked out with holiday decorations to celebrate the season. Millennials, older generations, bustling with crowds blasting Christmas music inside this Christmas village. Beyond the gigantic ornament-laden trees and dazzling light displays at department stores, almost immediately, you feel it really is a Christmas and also feel really festive. There's definitely a greater need among the younger population to see something dazzling and glamorous about Christmas. That's why you see them flocking to the Hyundai Seoul. Another tips. Nearby this area are the large open space next to the Han River, which is called Yao Oi Du Hangung Park. It is really nice if you go there on the weekend afternoon, in the sunny day. You can rent out some mat and enjoy the sunset while drinking some hot coffee or a bowl of boiling Shin Ramyun instant noodle, which is you all can buy it at the many small shops next to River Bay. If you guys are hungry, the Hyundai Seoul has a restaurant on the basement floor. For those who want to have an experience of Korean dining, from the food court on the first two floors and the restaurant next to the large movie theater on the top floor. There are also the outdoor terraces that are open all year round and many boutiques dining area. About how to go to this place, the Hyundai Seoul. You can take a subway train and stop at the Yaoi Nalu station. After arrive the station, go to the exit 1. And then, just walk along the Yaoi Nalu Row Street in the southwest direction. Only the second block, you guys will see the Hyundai Seoul Department Store on the opposite corner of right-hand side. And you guys just take any escalator at the top floor. The last one. Number 5. Myeongdong Cathedral. This cathedral is the most famous cathedral in Seoul and has been open for decades. It is one of Seoul's famous landmarks, which you guys should not miss during visit the city. It is located near a number of shopping districts and shopping malls, as well as restaurants, cafes, and nightclubs. You guys might want to take a photo at the cathedral's entrance with many LED light decorated cover all of the area, The church was built in 1898. It is one of Seoul's oldest cathedral and features architecture design elements from European-style church. It was originally the Anglican church in Korea. Over the years, they have improved the church and added new buildings, cafes, and gift shops. The cathedral holds 4 daily masses in a day, 2 in the morning and 2 in the evening. At the early evening or in the night time, the area in front of cathedral offers beautiful lighting decoration during Christmas time, which can be seen from across this busy district every day in the winter season. The Mother Mary statue stands behind the church and there are people who go to pray there. The one highlight of this church is the crypt. It is located in the basement at the back of the church. There rest the remains of the 7 saints, which in the history these 7 martyrs were executed. As you guys see on the screen now, they use a lot of lights and decoration to create a very colorful festival atmosphere. On the opposite side of the cathedral, there are a nice cafe, Molto Cafe. If you guys were to come here at the late afternoon or near the sunset time, over there is the nice spot to take a photo too, especially on their open deck upper floor of this cafe. Okay. So if you guys watch until this last minute, I have to say, thank you so much. And if you all like this clips, please support me by press the subscribe and press like button below. That will help me a lot, and feel free to share this video clips to your friends and family. About how to came here, Myeongdong Cathedral. You guys just take any subway train to Myeongdong Station. After arrive, just go for the exit 6 or exit 8. Walk past through the Myeongdong Shopping Street, north direction, until the Myeongdong Gil Road. And turn right. 500 meters after that, the cathedral will be at your right hand side. Well, thank you for watching so much. And I'm looking forward to see you guys in the my next clips video content. My name is Izzy from Asian Update Trend Channel. See you on my next video.